Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to set up and run your first Angular project in Visual Studio Code. So I'll be showing you the entire procedure from downloading and installing Node.js, which is required to run Angular, as well as downloading Visual Studio Code, and also how to set up and run it there. So let's get started. So just go to Google and type download Node.js. You'll be getting the first link over here as nodejs.org. Just click it. And here you'll be having the Windows installer. If you are using Mac, you can use that particular one. I will go with Windows. I'll just click it. So it'll get started. And it is about 30 MB in size. So it will just take a few seconds. Yeah. So once it is downloaded, just click it and open when done. So you'll be getting the Node.js setup over here, the dialog box. Just click on next and just click on I accept. You can just like read it through and again click next. And this is the default location where Node.js is going to get installed. If you want, you can change it. I will like keep with the default one and I will click next. So these are some of the things that will be like automatically installed. So you can just like leave it to default and just click on next. Yeah, so this is fine. Just click next again and click on install. So once the installation is complete, just click on finish. And if you just go and search for Node.js, you'll be having this Node.js app. So once you're done installing Node.js, we need to add Node.js path to the environment variable. So just search for Node.js, you'll be getting this Node.js app. And here you'll be having an option called as open file location. Just click it and you'll be having the programs. And here you'll be having Node.js. Again, right click it and go to open file location. So you'll be getting the path where you have installed Node.js, which is local disk C, program files and Node.js. Just click here and copy this whole path. And after copying, just go to search again and type environment. You'll be having the edit the system environment variables option. Just click on open. And in this, you'll be having this environment variables. Click it. And under system variables, you'll be having path. Just click on path and then click on edit. And here you can see, right, C program files Node.js has been automatically added. So if it isn't automatically added, you need to just click on new and paste this path and click on OK. So just check if this path has been added already, okay? So once you're done adding this path, close everything and just go to search and open command prompt. So I will just zoom in a bit. So type node-v. So here you can see that we'll be getting the node version here. This means that we have successfully installed Node.js. So also type npm-v. Yeah, so we will be also having the npm node package manager, which allows us to install many packages like libraries and stuff. So now we are done installing with Node.js, and yeah, next thing we want to download is our IDE, which is Visual Studio Code. So just type download Visual Studio Code. You will be having the first link as code.visualstudiocode.com. Click it, and here it will be having for Windows and Linux and Mac exact same thing. Like just click on it, your download will be getting automatically started. And thank you for downloading. Yeah, it will get automatically started and you can just like click open when done and install it. It's so simple. I've already like installed Visual Studio Code on my system. And even if you still want to watch how it's getting downloaded and installed, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. I have done an entire tutorial on how to download Visual Studio Code. Okay. So now we are done installing both Visual Studio Code as well as Node.js. So now let's begin to create our Angular.js project. So for that, just go to Google and type Angular. You'll be getting these links over here. Here, click on Getting Started Tutorial. And to the left, you'll be having tutorials. Click that and you need to click on your first Angular app and introduction. If you scroll down, we'll be having this command, which is npm install -g @angular/cli. Okay, we have already done installing Node.js. So just copy this command. Or else you can just type it out, that's your choice. Go to search, open your command prompt and paste it and run this command. So this will basically install Angular CLI. Now to check the version, you need to run ng /v. That's it, hit enter. So I'm getting an error saying ng is not recognized as an internal or external command. So for solving this issue, you need to just open your this PC, you need to go to local disk C, and you need to go to users, then your system username. In this, we will be having the app data folder, but this is a hidden folder. So if this folder is not visible to you, you need to click on this view and you need to check on this hidden items. So if I uncheck it, I won't be able to see it. So you need to just make sure that you are checking this view hidden items. And we will be having this app data, click it, go to roaming, and if you scroll down, we'll be having this npm folder. Double click it. So I'll just copy this path, and we are having ng over here, right? Just copy this whole path and go to your search, type for environment. You'll be getting the edit the system environment variables. Open it, and here click on environment variables. You need to go to path under system variables or user variables. That's your choice. I will go under system variables. Click on edit, new, paste this path. Click on OK. OK here also. OK here also. Now just reopen your command prompt. OK, close it. Again go to search, command prompt, and the command which we ran is ng space v. Hit enter, and you can just click on no for this n. Hit enter, and here you can see currently we are getting our Angular CLI version perfectly, and these are the other necessary Angular libraries installed with their version. So now we are good with this, and next is going to be the folder where we are going to create our AngularJS project. So for doing this, you just need to go to any random folder or your desired folder. I will just go to my local disk C and new folder. I will just name it as Angular project. Now just open your Visual Studio Code. To the top, you will be having this file option. Click it, open folder, go and select your new folder that you created for your Angular project. Click it and just click on select folder. That's it. So yeah, I trust the authors. Now we are inside this folder. Just click on terminal, new terminal. Now we will be getting the same path in our terminal. Now you are running the command ng space new, and you need to give a name for your Angular app. So let me give it as demo app. This can be totally your choice. These two are going to be the keywords. Okay, and just hit enter. And last CSS, just hit enter. If you want to change it, you can change this. I am good with CSS. Just hit enter again, and I don't want this now, n for this. Hit enter. So this will basically install all the necessary files and folders for our Angular project. After all the necessary files are created, if we just expand our demo app folder, we'll be having all the files, the source app, everything will be there, dot TypeScript. So we'll be having everything over here. And now we need to go inside this demo app folder to start our application. So for that, it's going to be cd space the name of the folder that you gave for your application. In my case, it is demo app. So it's going to be cd space demo app and hit enter. So now we need to start our application. So for that, the command is going to be ng space serve and hit enter. We'll be getting application bundle generation complete. So we are also having a localhost path. So if you hover over it and you need to press on the control key and click it. So we will be getting our demo Angular project opened in our browser. So this is the, like the default app that we will be getting. So that's the video, guys. We have successfully ran our Angular project in Visual Studio Code. I hope you'd have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in programming as well as React.js, Node.js, CRUD operations, and OpenAI, Gemini AI, and other AI tutorials. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.